You don't have the right to give this child back to her, and it's not up to you. When you said she had that child and was doing drugs with that child on her lap, you know who's responsible for that? That's on your watch.
I realize that since I've gotten her back, that I can't give her back without relinquishing the guardianship.
Yeah, we need a serious wake-up call here. We need a serious wake-up call here. You need to remember this. You entered the system, and once you enter the system, you gave up control. And, you know, people that go into mental health get trained in different areas. And I was trained in clinical psychology and behavioral medicine and forensic psychology. Forensic psychology is psychology in the law. Forensic psychologists are the kind of psychologists that get appointed by the court to make determinations, oftentimes as ad litems for the child, as to whether or not someone is fit to parent a child. Not who's the most fit. Is anyone fit to parent the child? And then to review the records to see if those people are discharging their responsibilities in accordance with the court orders in the best interest of the child. You had no right to give that child back to her after 3 months, and it was highly irresponsible to do so, as you now know. Last month, did you get heroin for someone else? Not you. You didn't do it. You didn't take it. But did you assist someone else in getting heroin?
Yes. Okay. So I did not have any involvement with it besides gave him the phone number for that person.
So you assisted someone else. We won't say who it was because they're not here to defend themselves, but just you assisted someone else by giving them a drug connect.
I gave him one of the phone numbers to one of his friends.
And that person is caring for a child.
Yes.
So this person you gave the number to is caring for a child and wanted a number to get in touch with a drug dealer. And you said, yeah, here you go.
She actually...
And you followed them over there?
No, I did not.
You didn't drive behind them?
She told me she drove to the mall and waited so she could watch him get it.
Did you tell her that?
I told her that.
But you didn't do it. You just lied to her? Mm-hmm. You thought, I'm going to tell her a bad lie. I'm going to tell her something bad about myself just because I'm trying to impress her?
No, just to see what she'd say. Like, I tell her the truth. She thinks I'm lying either way whenever I am honest. So
I'm trying to get my child from my mother, so I'm going to tell her that I'm trafficking in a drug deal.
It wasn't the smartest thing to say.
Remember, I'm the guy that's wanting to get your daughter back, and you need to tell me the truth. And I don't believe what you're saying. That I'm going to tell my mother something bad about me so she's less likely to give me my daughter back?
I don't think she's had any intention to give her back in a long time. So I told her something, joking
sure,
around
to
see what she would
bad.
Say.
Okay. Yeah, doesn't wash. It's either a bad lie or poor judgment. You said you would never, ever put Avery in harm's way. You said you never have and never would. Mm-hmm. But that's historically not true. She was born with drugs in the umbilical cord. Mm-hmm. So you put her in harm's way that may impact her for the rest of her life.
Yeah.
Well, hey, it's me, and thank you so much for watching. And while I have you, do you have a story or a question for me? If so, trust me, I want to hear from you. Click on the link in the description and tell me what in the world is going on. You just might end up right here on the show. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. Click that little red button below. You know you want to. What are you waiting for? Do it!